This message comes from Progressive Insurance, where drivers who switch could save hundreds on car insurance. Get your quote at progressive.com today. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates.
Just so you know, this episode includes a few mentions of drug use and domestic abuse.
The aftermath of my pain is a different cycle. Trying to just beat my case like my name is Michael. Trying to break the cycle, even for my kids. Yeah, I refuse to let them live like I used to live.
Anthony Johnston is a good kid who just can't seem to get the chip off his shoulder.
It's time to change my man's insane. So tired of living day to day. Can't even walk up to the park to see my little babies play. The food is trash. The guards are cruel. I should have stayed my stupid telling school.
And during his time at the Richmond City Jail, Anthony's learning how to cope with the conflicts that always seem to be brewing on the inside. He's trying to put his troubles down in rhyme instead of acting out on them like he's always done in the past.
And my priorities in life was wrong and misconstrued, but now I'm a different dude because I got stuff to lose. I wrote the truth so y'all can have something to listen to. Hopefully I get it through all the dreams I didn't do. I remember being in my cell while I'm missing you.
But he's had a tough time making progress in his reentry program. And with no support network waiting for him on the outside, can he avoid getting trapped in here again? From Narratively and VPM, this is Track Change. I'm Speech Thomas, a musician and part of the hip-hop collective Arrested Development. And Anthony is one of nearly 2 million people locked behind bars in the United States.
Concrete barriers, golden gray.
We're at the Richmond City Jail in Virginia, and I'm here as part of the REAL program. That's Recovery from Everyday Addictive Lifestyles.
Good Lord, carry my soul away.
REAL's goal is to help incarcerated people stay sober and stay free after they've been released. And I'm joining the program to work with talented songwriters, singers, and rappers. We're recording an album to chronicle their lives as they try to break free of the cycle that's trapped them.
Rage and pain bearing down on me. Been so long since I've been free.
My brother.
How you doing, sir?
I'm doing good, man. How are you?
The first time we were supposed to meet, Anthony missed our studio session. He had broken the REAL program rules, and so his privileges were suspended.
I got in trouble, man. They weren't trying to let me back in there, man.
Yeah,
I was getting in trouble.
I heard that.
I got some behavior.
Because I was looking forward to actually doing more recording, and then things changed.
Anthony originally joined the REAL program to work on his addiction to narcotics, but his love of hip-hop drew him to the recording studio.
Like, I heard two verses, and I was like, man, this brother's spitting. It reminded me of, like, Talib Kweli or something, the way he was flowing. Yeah. I was like, man, this brother's killing it.
I love music. Music has influenced me a lot, and if I would have got off course, you know, I might have been able to play some instruments or something of that nature, but now all I got is spoken word and a little bit of flow. You know what I mean?
Unlike Garland or Teddy, Anthony hasn't had any experience in a recording studio. But he knows his style, he knows what he's trying to do, and he knows what he wants to say.
I like Schoolboy Q, I like Nas, I like Kendrick Lamar, I like people that actually are rapping about something.
Anthony tells me he used to rap about crime and drugs, but he doesn't want to do that anymore.
I got two children. My son is 4 years old, and my daughter is 2 years old, and I'm 21. I'm a kid with kids.
Right.
Can't deal with it no more, man. I gotta be a father to them.
I think it's important for Anthony to be a good role model to his children because he never had that with his own parents. His dad was murdered when Anthony was very young. His stepfather was incredibly violent. And his mom...
She dealt with a whole lot of depression issues when it came to alcoholism and drug abuse. Like, my mom smoked weed so much that I literally thought it was just a thing that human beings do until I got in trouble for it.
Before he found himself in jail, Anthony sold drugs and took drugs. He was even unhoused for 2 years. He entered the criminal legal system as a teenager. Right now, he's waiting for a sentence on multiple charges.
One charge is grand larceny, The other charge is B&E.
Breaking and entering.
Then I have a credit card larceny, then I have another grand larceny. So I have four felonies, and the other two misdemeanors are petty larceny and vandalism.
It's definitely a no-joke situation for Anthony, but he wants to start fresh, and he says that he's ready to get clean.
Intellectually, I'm pretty smart. I'm smart enough to survive, but I'm stupid enough to be in here. Like, I had the tools, you know what I mean? But I had my priorities misconstrued. Right, I'm exactly. In a real program. I haven't gotten in any fights since I've been here.
Right.
Which I usually do. And, right. You know what I mean? Hopefully the judge looks at that. I don't think I'm going to prison this time.
Yeah.
The last time. I'm never going to come back here again.
Yeah, I feel you, bro.
I can't sing for real, but I think it's a song.
Okay.
But I
got some. Down in the studio, Anthony hesitates. He starts flipping through pages of lyrics he's written, throwing different ideas at me.
Okay.
I don't even think it goes like, love is a cliche. Yeah, that's what they say. I paid the bills, but it's like this. Love is a cliche. Yeah, that's what they say. I paid the bills, but now I'm broken. That's off yesterday's pay. I understand that in this land, there are only some that play fair. Like in the 80s, being black in the bus won't take my fare.
Nice.
And I don't really know what I was doing right here at the bottom, but I don't know what I was doing. Man, that day I was just going through it, man. That's just some, you know
what I
mean?
I like that. That's nice.
That's just some stress, man, you know what I mean?
In the studio with Anthony, I have to make myself smaller so that he could take up space in the room. So in working with him, I shrink myself, in a sense, to try to lift him up.
Yeah, that's right. That's the best way to do it.
And as we keep going, I can see him gaining confidence whenever I compliment him. Like, he needs to hear it.
And I got another jump, and it's not finished, but it's just being locked. It's like, how it goes, being locked down in my cell, I'm too used to this. It's like, damn, I'm too used to this. Look, man, I got to show you what it sound like on the beat, man. The beat sound hard with it, you know what I mean?
Anthony loves Future, and I could tell that riffing off of a Future joint that he already knows and is familiar with is helping him get way more comfortable. So now I'm setting him up with a similar rhythm so he can work on his own lyrics.
I want to go ahead and get a beat per minute on that joint, so let me see. So
I'm too used to this. Coming back and forth to jail, I'm too used to this. Holding pain behind my eyes, I'm too used to this.
That's nice, Anthony. That's hot. I'm too used to this. I want you to sing that chorus again.
Alright.
Here you go.
Coming back and forth to jail, I'm too used to this. Being locked down in my cell, I'm too used to this. Holding pain behind my eyes, I'm too used to this. Telling family members lies, I'm too used to this.
Nice, that was a killer. You did great. Yeah, brother, it feels good.
Anthony's battling between two realities. Part of him is hurt, and it's obvious. He's crushed from things that have happened to him, and also things that haven't happened for him, like people that haven't helped him and things that haven't gone his way. So he's put up this wall of like, I'm good. I don't need anybody's help. I don't need any of these things. And at the same time, he can recognize and say, I need all of those things. But how do I cope with life if they're not coming to me?
But Anthony, you're locked up and dealing with this.
Anthony has gotten 3 sanctions in 1 week. He's been acting up, taking his frustrations out on the other members of the program and staff. Sarah Scarborough, who runs the real program, pulls him into a small room. She's making a kind of intervention, which she does whenever Anthony blows off his chores or starts an argument. She points at another man.
Look at him. Look at old man over here. He didn't get it right when he was locked up, and so what does that mean? He's mid-50s and back in here.
Sarah is the program director, but she's not just like holed up in her office dealing with paperwork and stuff. I mean, she's often right there on the 6th floor, which is a jail floor dedicated solely to the real program. Sarah's goal is to give these men a real chance of getting to the root of their behaviors. And she's particularly focused on Anthony because he's the young guy. And Sarah believes that if he can just build some critical skills right now, learn to manage his emotions, then maybe he won't have to spend the next decade or two in jail.
You just said you feel better after you fight. That's a problem.
I know, man.
That's a problem. So what are you going to do to get that adrenaline rush, but in a completely different way?
I don't know, because it's not like that when I'm on the streets. It's only when I get in here.
Yeah, but what are you doing on the streets to numb yourself?
Getting high.
Okay, so you don't have feelings when you're high.
Yeah, and I just got them all back, and it's just scary. Yeah.
Right.
Sarah's definitely pushing Anthony, but it's because she knows that once he's released, he doesn't have anybody to give him support on the outside. So she's in a race against the clock to help him become more resilient, more able to follow through on what he wants to accomplish.
And so what is underlying the fight?
Depression, trauma, mental insecurities, and behavioral issues.
What phase are you on?
One.
How long have you been in this program?
A long time.
The real program has a curriculum. It has four phases. And the first phase deals with personal reflection, and it goes all the way to the last phase, which is very practical stuff like budgeting and job interviews. All the men work at their own pace, but Anthony has been in this for quite a while, 5 months in jail, and he hasn't made any progress. He's still on the first phase.
You know the problem. You don't know how to deal with it. And you are not putting forth the effort to figure it out. And if you were to get out today or tomorrow, Anthony, I would put money on the fact that you would use within 24 hours. No question. Because you do not know how to deal with life on life terms. You have got to get through it when you're here and start dealing with it and learning how to cope with this painful, painful stuff.
All right, I'm doing what I gotta do.
All right, well, go finish your lock-in. I want to see a chapter of phase work tomorrow.
All right, I got you.
All right.
Thank you, Ms. Sarah.
You're welcome.
This message comes from NPR sponsor Shopify, the global commerce platform that helps you sell and show up exactly the way you want to. Customize your online store to your style. Sign up for a $1 per month trial period at shopify.com/NPR.
This message comes from Carvana. Whether you need weeks to research the perfect car or know exactly what you want, Carvana makes car buying easy. Choose from Carvana's massive inventory using customizable search tools. However you buy, buy your car with Carvana. This message comes from our sponsor, Grainger. This is the story of the one. As a maintenance engineer, he hears things differently. To the untrained ear, everything on his shop floor might sound fine, but he can hear gears grinding or a belt slipping. So he steps in to fix the problem at hand before it gets out of hand. And he knows Grainger's got the right product he needs to get the job done, which is music to his ears. Call, click Grainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Travel can broaden horizons, build relationships, and rejuvenate the soul. But it often comes at a cost. Peak Travel is a new podcast about how tourism shapes communities and destinations around the world. I'm your host, Tariro Mzazoa. Listen to Peak Travel from WHYY, part of the NPR network.
1, 2, 3, and.
God take the lead so I can follow, just so I can make it to tomorrow, huh? Take the lead so I can follow, just so I can make it to tomorrow, huh?
Ah, man, I can't rap slow like that, man. I rap fast talking about money and drugs and stuff. It's right, hard, right, man. It actually irritates me.
Yeah.
Because I'm trying to change so much, man.
That's
talking
good.
About this positivity is very hard to do.
Well, see, brother.
If you put me on a freestyle, give me a blunt and a bottle, I could just rip it.
Right.
You know what I mean? But it's going to be about negative stuff. So this, for me, is hard and it's embarrassing because I'm choking.
Don't be embarrassed, brother. Don't be embarrassed. You know what I mean? You're doing this. This is the right. This is the path you said you were on, and I agree. It's right, and you're putting it down on wax, so it's supposed to take time. And this is the same with anybody else, Future, Teddy, anybody. So it's supposed to take time. It's good. This is good. The process is right.
If you've been playing with Legos all your life, how are you going to build a building?
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? I'm not an architect. So right. It's crazy. They can hear me out there?
Nah.
Oh,
I mean, maybe a little bit.
Yeah, he just said yes, so that's okay. Wicked. That's wicked. But yeah, man,
No, this is right.
All right.
Anthony, it sounds good.
All right.
Have a seat.
Sarah's still trying to break through to Anthony.
I just wanted to follow up on the conversation we had this morning. Why, Anthony, do you think you're playing the victim role?
I don't know. I just feel like...
Sarah's helping Anthony recognize a pattern that he lashes out when he feels frustrated and gives up when things don't go the way he thought they would. So Anthony could make all the music he wants to make, but people won't be able to get along with him if he doesn't work on these seemingly small but destructive things that he does. And that starts with figuring out why he does it in the first place.
It's just hard for me to take responsibility for my actions unless I'm forced to, and I'm so used to fighting. I'm so used to just fighting, so.
Where
just,
has that gotten you, though?
Nowhere.
Look down. What are you wearing?
Yeah.
That's where it's gotten you.
Jail. Yeah.
All right, so tell me, why do you think your reactions are always, like, instant bad?
Because I never cared about controlling them. Like, once my life spiraled downhill, like, my girl left me and took my kids with her, I didn't care about anybody. So I'm just learning how to care about myself, but I don't even love myself yet. Mm-hmm. So I'm trying to work on loving myself so that I can be able to love the people around me.
After speaking with his lawyer, Anthony has some surprising news.
My lawyer came to see me and told me that the Commonwealth said that my case is too complicated. They don't feel like dealing with it. And they'll be willing to give me time served in something called DRC.
Basically, Anthony's case might get thrown out, letting him out of jail much earlier than anyone expected.
But I do need some help. I don't have any housing, no nothing to fall back on, and I ain't trying to be another statistic.
So tomorrow when you get out, if you can say, this is what I want to happen to get me to where I need to be, what would your dream be?
Be in a real house.
Why is that?
Because I know there's going to be people around me that wants me to succeed.
The Real House is transitional housing, part of the Real program, but on the outside. So there's meetings, check-ins, and most importantly, other men to give support. But the Real House also comes with strict rules. And Anthony's already been kicked out of the Real program before for blowing off his responsibilities and being disrespectful to other members. He hasn't proved to Sarah that he could comply with these rules.
So why should I have faith and consider you coming to the Real House?
I don't expect you to have faith in me. I did totally wrong, so.
Why should I have faith that you're not going to lash out when you're out there?
Because if you did have faith in me and I came in the Real House, right, and I messed up and you kicked me out, then that's that. But if I went to the Real House and I was successful and I changed my life around, how would you feel? That's all I can say.
The news about Anthony's pending release is taking everybody by surprise, including Sarah. And so right now she's having to decide whether she's going to be the one to put a roof over his head.
I'm willing to give you a shot.
For real?
Mm-hmm.
I really appreciate that.
That'd be nice. Did you hear me? That wasn't plural. That was singular. Shot. I said a shot. Not like you had in here. And so if you go to that house, you will follow the rules. End of story. And if not, it will kill me having to say, Anthony, you gotta go. And it would kill me knowing that you're gonna be sleeping on the corner. Mm-hmm. But business is business. And there are expectations. So you gotta get a... We'll figure out the job situation. Usually you have to have a job within 2 weeks. So we will work that piece out. Once you get a job and get a paycheck, it's $135 a week.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? That's how we pay for the house. You have 90 meetings in 90 days.
Anthony also has to put in 10 hours of community service every week, random drug tests, and he's got to commit to this for 6 months.
Can you do it?
Yeah, I can do it.
Look at me in the eye right now, making a commitment to me.
I can definitely do it. I know that.
Okay. I'm taking your word as a man, Anthony. Don't let me down.
Given his lack of improvement in the Real program, Anthony hasn't really lowered his risk of being arrested and incarcerated again. Sarah knows all of this, But she knows that letting him stay at the Real House is probably the best chance that he'll have.
This message comes from NPR sponsor Shopify, the global commerce platform that helps you sell and show up exactly the way you want to. Customize your online store to your style. Sign up for a $1 per month trial period at shopify.com/NPR. This message comes from NPR sponsor Sattva. You hear a lot of statistics during elections. Here's another. Over a third of Americans suffer from sleep deprivation. Sattva offers handcrafted mattresses to help you sleep soundly. Visit SAATVA.com/NPR.
This message comes from Schwab. At Schwab, how you invest is your choice, not theirs. That's why when it comes to managing your wealth, Schwab gives you more choices. You can invest and trade on your own. Plus, get advice and more comprehensive wealth solutions to help meet your unique needs. With award-winning service, low costs, and transparent advice, you can manage your wealth your way at Schwab. Visit Schwab.com to learn more.
Wait, don't tell me. Fresh air, up first. NPR News Now, Planet Money, TED Radio Hour, Throughline, the NPR Politics Podcast, Code Switch, Embedded, Books We Love, Wildcard, are just some of the podcasts you can enjoy sponsor-free with NPR Plus. Get all sorts of perks across more than 20 podcasts with the bundle option. Learn more at plus.npr.org.
Today, Anthony is being released. He'll be on parole, and he'll have to check in regularly with law enforcement to stay free.
But when I woke up, I just prayed, and but when I prayed, I didn't pray for what I want. I didn't pray for me to go home. I didn't pray, God, please let me go home. I'm going to do it again. I prayed, and I said, God, let your will be done for me, please.
But not long after, Anthony's told there's an issue with paperwork. Sarah gets on the phone and tries to sort things out.
I just talked to Anthony's attorney, and the previous PR bond and the...
There seems to be a holdup, which may stop Anthony from getting out today.
Okay, so I just talked to records, and the... Come a little bit closer.
Here we go.
No, don't freak out. So, don't worry, we're gonna get it taken care of, all right? Positive attitude, you asked for God's will, right?
Anthony is getting frustrated.
Sir, I served my time.
Listen,
I took a plea. It's not a bond.
We're not going to get disrespectful.
I'm not getting disrespectful.
Yes, you are.
My voice even. I'm not.
Yeah, but I just need you to work on your attitude.
You don't think I have a reason to be mad, don't you, sir? That makes it. Can you hear what I'm saying? I appreciate you working for me, but listen to what I'm saying. That's not correct.
Sarah signals for a timeout.
Why I'm getting frustrated with you is this is not Anthony's world. Situations are going to happen that you don't like, and things are going to rise, right? What's the first part of the serenity prayer?
Grant me the serenity.
To do what? Accept the things I cannot change? You don't have to like it, but you're gonna have way more disappointment in life than the opposite, right? You've just gotta figure out how to stay calm and collected. What did you say you got on your knees and prayed about?
For God's will to be done.
Right, okay. He's done what you've asked, and his will is not for you to get out today.
But when God doesn't let you out one day, there's always hope for the next. And 3 days later, Anthony is freed.
When I came in, I was swagged out in the wintertime, you feel me?
He's still good. All right. Yeah, so you're going to stand on that wall right over there for me?
Right over there.
As he goes through the release procedures, Anthony could barely contain himself.
All right, you ready?
First, he wants to get something to eat. Then he wants to shower. Then he needs some clothes. He wants to get his hair cut.
No, this is your show. Let's see this on the way out. Hopefully you won't see it no more.
You want to see this dude on the way out?
Anthony's co-parent, the mother of his kids, doesn't know that he's getting released. So he wants to get his situation settled before he tells them, and he wants to get a job so he can start supporting them.
That'll do, mate. That'll do.
He picks up his belongings. Now he's carrying everything that he came here with. And then he steps outside.
Oh my God. Freedom. Freedom.
He bends down and he's kissing the ground.
Home free home. I don't know, I know this freedom feels amazing, baby. Whew. I got some dirt up in my mouth for real. Dirt up in my junk. That's all right, man. God is good. I can't believe I'm free. Can't believe I'm free. Which way we going, Miss Sarah?
I gotta give it to him, I gotta give it to him, I gotta give it to him, I need to give it to him, I need to give it to him, so I'ma give it to him. It's the truth, truth, truth.
God, take the lead so I can follow, just so I can make it to tomorrow, huh? Take the lead so I can follow, just so I can make it to tomorrow.
Yeah, I'm from the dungeon where things happen for no reason. People getting high as ever and ODing. They overseeing their own demons. And then they start crying when their lungs stop breathing. Our minds bleeding. It's time to get it right. We might lead this kryptonite. People start talking about God. That's like our kryptonite. All we worry about is our girl and if we did it right. If we tough enough and we gangsta enough to live this life. It's time to change it though. Switch and rearrange the flow. Just because I'm stacking money don't make me no gangster though. So I'm about to switch it up. Get out this box and buy a truck, but that ain't coming from no luck. I gotta get some paper. And if I really want a truck, I gotta do some labor. And if I'm really going to change, I gotta love my neighbor. We gotta stop the hating and stop the perpetrating. With all this purpose wasting, man, the devil is just waiting. Yeah, I'm talking about Satan. And this ain't no Christian rap. But if you do not like the truth, then you could give it back. Cause I'm tired of seeing this, and I'm tired of being that. And I'm tired of being in the jungle, living with the rats and the jets. I'm a vet, so it's time to intercept with my life purpose. I know my kids and my wife worth it. Then the drugs and the pain worth. Dang, my lungs and my brain's hurting, cause the stain's lurking.
God, take the lead so I can follow, just so I can make it to tomorrow, huh? Take the lead so I can follow, just so I can make it to tomorrow, huh? Tired of recidivism, I'm tired of being in the system. Tired of recidivism, I'm tired of being in the system. Tired of recidivism, I'm tired of being in the system. Yeah.
On the next episode, Devante.
I used to smoke and drink just to unwind. So many days and days they passed me by. It was another pain I overcame. But my problems only seemed to circulate.
Devante is a smart, sensitive, well-liked guy with a lot of potential. He's about to get released and reunite with his family. But that isn't so simple, because for as long as Devante can remember, his whole family has been tied up with drug use and crime. Will he be able to shake off their legacy and make his own way? Track Change is made by Narratively and VPM and distributed by the NPR Network. This season was produced by Liz Mack, James Boo, Needy Shastri, and Noah Rosenberg. Fact check by Sarah Hershander, audio mix by Sound Sanctuary, and theme music by Garland Carr and Renzo Gorio. Special thanks to Anthony for sharing part of his life with the world. This season was adapted from original footage from the documentary film 16 Bars. With support from the filmmakers at Resonant Pictures. You can watch the film at 16barsthefilm.com. Songs from the 16 Bars original motion picture soundtrack are used with permission from the copyright holders. Anthony's song, Recidivism, courtesy of Eric Michaels. If you want to hear the complete song, check out trackchange.vpm.org. This podcast was originated by our consulting producer, Sammy Dane. Sam Bathrick was also a consulting producer. Our executive producers are Noah Rosenberg, Joe Lamont, and me, Speech Thomas. Our producers from VPM are Meg Lindholm and Gavin Wright. VPM's chief content officer is Steve Humble. To learn more about the work that REAL is doing to help formerly incarcerated people stay free in Virginia, visit reallifeprogram.org. See y'all next time.
This message comes from NPR sponsor Betterment. The drama of having an enemy-turned-lover is never chill, but your investing portfolio should be. Betterment is the investing app that lets you be totally chill about your finances. Their automated tech makes it easy to get in the market and stay in the market. Save the drama for that moment when you realize your mortal enemy is actually your soulmate. Betterment. Be invested. And totally chill. Learn more at Betterment.com. Investing involves risk. Performance is not guaranteed.
This message is brought to you by NPR sponsor Progressive Insurance. You call the shots on what's in your podcast queue. Now you can call them on your auto insurance, too, with the Name Your Price tool from Progressive. Tell Progressive how much you want to pay for car insurance, and they'll show you coverage options within your budget. Get your quote today at Progressive.com. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.
Studies have shown that elections can spike feelings of stress and anxiety. That's why NPR's Pop Culture Happy Hour is there to help you feel more grounded as we talk about the buzziest TV, movies, and music. Try a show on HBO's Industry or a roundtable on rom-coms to take a step back from the news of the day, at least before you plunge back in tomorrow. New episodes every week on Pop Culture Happy Hour from NPR.